The sniper takes careful aim at his target, fires the shot, and misses. The shot was off by just a few feet, but enough to make sure the target gets away clean. Not only that, but the shot will likely alert him to trouble in the area, and he'll be able to trigger local forces to hunt down the sniper. Or not, because as the bullet is fired, it changes direction and zeroes in on the target, hitting him dead center and eliminating the threat. Another successful mission for Smart Bullet. Science fiction or something else? Is the military on the verge of giving its soldiers bullets that can think? For most of us, our first memory of homing weapons probably comes from video games. Feels like a dirty trick when the boss fires his weapons and suddenly they start bearing down on you. It was also a common trope in sci-fi movies, when the enemy's ship weapons seemed to have a mind of their own. But in reality, there have been homing weapons for a long time. The most common is probably guided missiles, where the weapon can be controlled from the base to change direction, kind of like guiding a drone, except this drone isn't supposed to make it back to base. But other weapons can change direction on their own. The first type of homing missile that could move independently was the infrared homing missile, which could lock onto a target's heat signature and change direction as needed to hit a target. These have been in development from World War II, but have advanced a lot and can now target vehicles out of their line of sight by following the heat signal. These are dangerous weapons of war, but they tend to be large-scale weapons and they're not very useful in crowded situations where there are plenty of potential targets, which makes this new weapon a potential game-changer. Meet the X-Acto Sniper Rifle, short for Extreme Accuracy Tasked Ordnance. If it sounds like a weapon you get in a video game, you're not too far off. This is the most advanced gun ever created, and it's currently under development by DARPA, the Defense Advanced Research Projects Agency. Developed by Lockheed Martin and Teledyne for the US government, it's one of the most promising projects at the agency, where many projects turn out to be unfeasible for combat use after extensive development. But this one might just have a big leg up. The technology for homing weapons has been in development for a long time, but had never been used on a weapon this small. And the need for this weapon is clear. Being a sniper is an unforgiving job. These elite shooters often find themselves contending with moving targets in unfavorable conditions, like high winds, dust storms, or rain. Some snipers even try to shoot from helicopters, one of the hardest possible positions. Top snipers need an extreme level of control over their body and an understanding of their environment, but sometimes even that might not be enough. So DARPA wants them to get a tech assist. The exact technology of the X-Acto rifle isn't known, but what we do know is that it's a combination of an advanced gun and bullets that might be the most advanced in the world. It's based off the 50 caliber BMG gun from Browning, and it comes with an improved sniper scope for maximum visibility. The ammunition is only half an inch long, which will be a challenge to get the high-tech components to fit in there. But what makes the X-Acto so impressive is that this isn't custom hardware. It's based off the existing BMG ammunition. But what is inside is truly impressive. Designing a whole new type of gun doesn't come quickly, and the X-Acto was first put into development in 2008. After several years of development, it was slated for completion in 2015. By 2014, it was ready for test firing, and a demonstration showed the capabilities of the X-Acto, a bullet that could be fired in the wrong direction and curve seamlessly toward its target before hitting it dead on. An expert shooter tested the gun and hit the target every time. Making it even more impressive, a rookie shooter tried as well, and they hit the target as well, thanks to the guided bullet. So what's the secret of this new weapon? That's the rub. It's classified. After all, the federal government isn't really in the business of broadcasting its new weapons to the whole world, especially not when they're still in development. That would make it very easy for other figures, both rival nations and private military contractors, to try to beat the Department of Defense to market. So what little we know about X-Acto is being carefully parceled out by the DoD when they want to build hype for the new weapon, or is being speculated about by outsiders. But what we do know is pretty impressive. When X-Acto was first announced, many speculated it would use typical fire-and-forget technologies that would allow the ammunition to move independently. These included advanced sighting, tamper-proofing, and a small internal power supply. While it's likely these would make it into the final project, it was equally interesting what it didn't have: any visible fins or steering mechanisms on the bullet itself. This sets it apart from a typical homing missile and indicates that the X-Acto ammo will function more like a bullet, just one with a mind of its own, and it might run circles around the competition. The bullet is believed to use a real-time optical guidance system that will allow it to process information as it comes in and change direction in a matter of seconds. After the bullet is fired, it can evolve its flight path, and many initial shots were taken deliberately off target to test this system. As long as the target is reasonably within the line of sight, the bullet can hunt it down. although it's not clear just how far this extends right now. This has the potential to make it easier for snipers to hit targets in low visibility or nighttime conditions, while right now snipers are at the mercy of nature. So it's no surprise that many competitors are on the case. Sometimes it's best to compete with yourself, so Sandia National Laboratories also began developing their own guided sniper round not long after DARPA. The two were developed independently with only the same logline, bullet that could follow its target. However, the Sandia one has some key differences. The Sandia bullet will use a laser-guided system, which is technology that has been used more extensively. This might mean it beats the X-Acto to market, but it might also be more vulnerable to interference. After all, lasers can be blocked, and many enemy armies have anti-laser technology they could deploy. And there's the more direct competition. The X-Acto had its first full test in 2014, and it was deemed to be advancing fast enough to continue development. But like most things when the government is involved, it isn't exactly moving fast. Another round of live-fire tests in 2015 showed further progress, but there was still work to be done, and now the competition wanted one too. In 2016, Russia announced it was starting to work on its own smart bullet, one that would be able to travel a whopping 6 miles to hit its target. Should the United States be worried? Well, probably not. Russia makes a lot of big boasts, but we've gotten our closest look at how their military functions today, and it's not very impressive in Ukraine. While they might have a smart bullet in development, odds are it's much further from completion than the United States version. After all, if they had high-tech bullets, they wouldn't be invading another country with Cold War-era tanks and guns and makeshift body armor on their draftees. Additionally, with Russia under heavy sanctions, it's unlikely they'll be able to get the resources for large numbers of bullets with a guiding computer inside them. Which raises the question, when is the US version going to be ready? The main question might not be when it's available, but if we ever know when it is. After all, the X-Acto Smart Bullet isn't going to be available for purchase at your local Walmart. Much as Jimmy and his hunting buddies down in North Carolina might like the idea of hunting a deer or a bear with self-guiding bullets, the government would not want the technology getting out there. Not to mention, it's not exactly the kind of thing you put down some cash for. It's estimated that each X-Acto bullet could cost over $100 per round once perfected, maybe up to $1,000. It's also likely to have limited combat utility. The X-Acto is a weapon with a very specific purpose, to zero in on a specified target and eliminate them. That means it'll likely need a certain level of quiet to do its job. In a busy battlefield, the X-Acto would likely not be much more useful than a standard bullet, if it didn't get confused and go awry. It's not clear if it's been tested in more intense combat theaters rather than sniper situations, but it seems clear it's a weapon designed for long-range combat rather than a new tool to win wars. But could it have any civilian uses? If the X-Acto proves itself in the military and the government is ready to let it play a larger role, it could potentially revolutionize policing. Guided ammo could make the job of police officers easier, but it would also likely be prohibitively expensive. After all, those bullets don't come cheap, and many people would worry that giving the police more advanced weapons would just result in more effective lethal shots. Which raises the question, when is the X-Acto likely to be used? Due to the price, it's not likely to replace standard sniper bullets. After all, the best snipers around are more than capable of handling most missions thanks to their training. But there are those missions that are just a little trickier and have a few more variables, and maybe one of them involves a target that the United States just can't let get away. Say a key Al-Qaeda operative is being moved in the middle of a sandstorm, and the US gets one shot at him before he heads back underground. The US military is likely to deploy its best sniper and give them his X-Acto ammo to make sure that if he's not able to make the perfect shot, the gun will do the rest of the work. Which means that it's likely the X-Acto will eventually make the difference in key combat situations, but the average person may never know it. Want to know more about DARPA? Check out most insane weapons the US military is actually using today, or watch Most Lethal Modern Military Weapons for the best of the best.